Good morning, students. Today we will continue with the lesson. Lesson number 2, location and extent. In the last 2 lectures, we have studied about the location and the boundaries of India and Brazil. Today we will start with historical background of India and historical background of Brazil. Before we start, we'll review about what we have studied in the previous lecture. We have studied about the definition of location, extent, and boundary. A location is the place where something happens or is situated. The location of something or someone is their exact position. Definition of extent, the area covered by something, the particular degree to which something is or is believed to be the case. Definition of boundary, the line which marks the limit of an area, a dividing line, boundary, in reference to a country, city, state, territory, or like most often designated a line on a map. Then we have seen India is located in the northern and eastern hemisphere of the earth. It is located in the southern part of Asian continent. The mainland of India is extended 8° 4' north to 37° 6' north latitude and 68° 7' east to 97° 25' east longitude. The southernmost tip of India is the Indira Point, which is located in the latitude of 6° 45' north parallel. We have seen the different states of India. There are total 29 states in India. Then we have studied of 7 union territories of India, Chandigarh, New Delhi, Daman and Diu, Dagra and Nagar Haveli, Lakshadweep, Puducherry and Andaman and Nicobar. We have studied about the emblem of India also. The state emblem of India is a national emblem of the Republic of India is called, is an adapted of the lion capital of Ashoka. From 250 BCE at Sarnath, preserved in Sarnath Museum near Varanasi. It has 4 lions that faces 4 different directions, namely north, east, south, and west. Then we have studied about the country Brazil, Federative Republic of Brazil, and the capital of Brazil is Brasilia. Brazil has got its name from the local wooden tree, Pau Brazil. South part of the Brazil lie in the northern hemisphere, while most of it lie in the southern hemisphere. Also, it lies in the western hemisphere in the northern part of the South America continent. On observing the map, we get to know that the Brazil is extended 5° 15' north to 33° 45' south latitude, 34° 45' west to 73° 48' east longitude. Then we have studied the states of Brazil. Brazil has 26 states and 1 federal directive. The states are generally based on historical conventional borders which have developed over time. The states are divided into municipalities, while the federal district assumes the competences of both state and municipality. We have studied of the emblem of Brazil. The coat of arms of Brazil was created on 19 November 1889, 4 days after Brazil became a republic. The coat of arms consists of a central emblem surrounded by coffee and tobacco branches, which were the import crops in Brazil at that time. In the blue circle, the center, the southern cross can be seen. We have also studied about the continent of the world, Asia, Europe, Africa, North America, South America, Australia, Antarctica. These are the 7 continents of the world. Oceans of the world we have seen, Pacific Ocean, Indian Ocean, Atlantic Ocean, Arctic Ocean, and Southern Ocean. We We have also learned about the difference between the location of Brazil and India. Seeing the difference, we can say that India is located completely in the northern and eastern hemisphere. For Brazil, we can see some part of Brazil lies in the northern hemisphere, while most of it lies in southern hemisphere. Second point in difference, we can study that India is located in the southern part of the continent of the Asia. Related to Brazil, it is Brazil is located in the northern part of the continent of South America. This was the difference between the location of Brazil and India. Today, we will start with the historical background of India. As we all know that India was under the British rule for almost 1.5 centuries. We have studied about the British rule, how the Britishers rule on our India, how we get freedom. The British rule was for 1.5 centuries in India. India got independence in the year 1947. India got independence on 15 August 1947. Despite facing several problems, like three wars, famine situation in various parts, similar issues after independence, India is a major developing country of the world. After independence, students, India has faced various problems related to the financial, related to the settlement, industries, development, new technology. India has to struggle very hard for the development of each and every sector. India has to face several problems like three wars, which have happened in past. The famine situation in various parts of the India. A similar various situations, India, after independence, India is the major developing country. India has proved itself that it is a developing country. It has tried very hard in all the sectors for the development, and it has been a developing country in the world. Still, it is developing in various sectors such as education, health, new technologies. India is considered to be a global market. India is also considered for a global market. There is various import and export of goods. There is various import and export business. Economy is also developing because of import and export. So India is considered to be a global market. Various things are exported of India to the other countries, and import is also done in India. So this gave rise to a global market in India. Because of various economic reforms from time to time, Indian economy development has faced problems. As we have seen, India has struggled very hard for the development in every sector, in every section of it. Economic reforms from time to time. As the time changes, new technology India has adopted, various new inventions it has done, new provision, new implementation in every sector, in every field. India has given his tough for the development. So due to time to time changes, India has coped itself with it. And India's economic development has faced up. Economic development of India is also developed due to all this, because of global market also India has been in profit due to import and export business, various international good relations with the other countries. By taking help of other countries in, for example, inventions, new technologies. And Indian technologies also being used by the other countries. So this all gave rise to the economic development in India. The proportion of youth in India's population is high. As we see in India, the proportion of youth population is very high because the population, percentage of population engage in occupation field, engage in working, is of young generation as compared to other countries or as compared to Brazil. So the proportion of youth in India's population is very high. As this forms a major part of working population, India is looked upon as a young country. In India, the population age of population is related to youth age. Young people are more in India. So the working population automatically increases of the youth people, of the young people. So India look upon as a young country. We have to keep in mind, you have to remember this, India look upon as a young country. Why? Because major part of working population in India is of young generation or of young age. So India was under the British rule for almost 1.5 century. India got independence on 15 August 1947. India has to face various several problems like pre-war, famine situation in various parts of the country after independence. But it has tried is very well and developed in every sector. India is a major developing country of the world. India is considered to be a global market also because of its import, export and its business worldwide. Because of various economic reforms from time to time, due to the time to time changes, economic reform, economic status of India is also being developed and increased. The proportion of youth in India population is high. As this forms a major part of working population, India is looked upon as a youth country. Now we will see historical background of Brazil. For more than 3 centuries, Brazil was under Portuguese rule. As we know that India was under the British rule, like that Brazil was under the rule of Portuguese. And it was for near about or more than 3 centuries. So, on Brazil, Portuguese rule for 3 centuries. Brazil gained its independence in 1822. Brazil got its independence in 1822 from the Portuguese. From 1930 to 1985, the period from 1930 to 1985, for more than a half century, it was under the populist military government. After independence in 1822 from the Portuguese, from the period 1930 to 1985, for more than half century, the period was more than half century, it was under a populist military government. Brazil was under the populist military government. It has overcome global financial difficulties in the 20th century. Brazil is also developing country, but it has overcome global financial difficulties in 20th century. Brazil is seen as a contributor to economic growth of the world and an important market in the future. Brazil is seen as the important market in future. Brazil is also developing, but as compared to India, it is not that much developed as India has developed country. So Brazil is seen as a contributor to economic growth of the world. It also contributes to the economic growth of the world because there are various things which are also exported from Brazil to other countries. Brazil export is more than import. Brazil is also seen as an important market in future. This was the historical background of Brazil. Brazil, for more than 3 centuries, Brazil was under Portuguese rule. Brazil gained its independence in 1822 from 1930 to 1985 for more than a half century. It was under a populist military government. It has overcome global financial difficulties in the late 20th century. Brazil is seen as a contributor to economic growth of the world and an important marketing. So this is the difference between the India and Brazil and the historical background of India and Brazil that we have to keep the points in mind. Do you know? We celebrate our Independence Day on 15 August, whereas Brazil celebrates her Independence Day on September 7th. The date of Brazil independence is 7th September. Our independence, India's Independence Day is 15th August. And Brazil Independence Day is on September 7th. So we celebrate our Independence Day on August 15th, whereas Brazil celebrates our Independence Day on September 7th. India has federal parliamentary republic type of government, whereas Brazil has federal presidential republic type of government. Both of it have a republic type of government. India is also having republic type of government. Brazil is also having republic type of government. But the difference is India has federal parliamentary and Brazil has federal presidential. India's decisions are taken in parliamentary related to country and Brazil's decisions are presidential. So this is the difference between the government of India and Brazil. Federal parliamentary republic type of government in India. And Brazil has federal presidential type of government. The name Brazil comes from Pau Brazil, a local gudeg tree. As I have told you before, the name of the country Brazil comes from Pau Brazil, which is the name of a tree, a local wooded tree which is found in only Brazil. So the name given to the country Brazil. So we have to keep in mind or remember the date of independence of Brazil, that is 7th September. And the difference between the republic type of government, both they have republic type of government, but India has federal parliamentary and Brazil has federal presidential. India is looked upon as a young country. By studying the historical background, we have seen that India is looked upon as a young country. So there is the reason why it is looked upon as a young country. We will see in India, the percentage of working people. The percentage of working people is of young people in population is greater than non-working. The percentage of working people is more than that of non-working people and the working people population is of young people. The working people population is of young people in India. So this is one of the reasons why India look upon as a young country. In India, the percentage of working people in population is nearly 51%. Working people population in India is about 51%. In India, the percentage of non-working population. Non-working population is population related to children and senior citizens. Children are not allowed to work and senior citizen means that their age is past for work. Up to the limited age only a man or a human being can work. So in senior citizen, they do not have right to work. Most of the senior citizens are also working due to the financial condition. But the non-working population, we can see it's of children and senior citizens, is lesser than working population. So non-working population means children and senior citizens are less than the working population. Working population means young people. Therefore, India is looked upon as a young country. So India is looked up as a young country. So we can say that the percentage of working people in population, in give reason you can, in exam they can ask. India is looked upon as a young country. So you have to give the reason, because the percentage of working population is greater than non-working population. In India, the percentage of working people in population is nearly 51%. And the percentage of non-working population is lesser than working population. And the non-working population means children and senior citizens. This is the reason you have to keep in mind. Brazil is called coffee pot of the world. As we all know the reason why Brazil is called the coffee pot of the world. Brazil ranked first in the world in terms of production of coffee. This is the first main reason. Brazil ranked first in the world in terms of production of coffee. The production of coffee is more in Brazil. Brazil has coffee farms more as compared to other plants and other crops. The coffee farm is called as fazenda in Brazil. The name given for coffee plants are fazenda. In Brazil, it produces nearly 40% of total coffee production of the world. For the whole world, 40% of coffee is produced in Brazil. So it produces nearly 40% of the total coffee production of the world. It is the largest exporter of coffee. Brazil exports coffee in large scale as compared to the other countries. So Brazil is famous for coffee. Therefore, Brazil is called coffee pot of the world. In give reason, in exam they can ask why Brazil is called coffee pot of the world, and its main answer, you have to answer this. Brazil ranked first in the world in terms of production of coffee. It produces nearly 40% of total coffee production of the world. It is the largest exporter of coffee. Therefore, Brazil is called coffee pot of the world. After independence, Brazil and India, both are the countries which has faced many several problems related to every field, every sector, economical, financial, every related to health, education, job opportunities for the people, settlement, population. In every field, they have faced several problems. So after India, independence, face many financial crises. Financial crisis is the main problem faced by any country. As this country, as USA is a developed country, you don't have to see for any other crisis. But because it is financial development. But India and Brazil, the condition is different for them. So after independence, India faced many financial crises. Brazil, after independence, India and the problem slow rate of economic growth. By many financial difficulties and problems of slow rate of economic growth. Within 20 years after independence, India has fought 3 wars. India has fought 3 wars. 3 wars, there has much impact, harmful impact on India. and people from various parts of India coped with several famine growth. Famine was the main problem which faced by India. Current status of Brazil. Now we will see what is the current status, the present situation of Brazil. Brazil has also developed in various sectors now, for example, industries, technology, in agriculture field, mining, fishing, education, health. In Brazil was under the rule of Portuguese for more than three centuries. For more than three centuries, Brazil was under the Portuguese rule. So in this Portuguese rule also, Brazil has to face many several problems. They tried for independence a lot. So from 1930 to 1985, the period from 1930 to 1985, Brazil had a military government. As we have seen in the previous point also, in the historical background of India, then Brazil had a military government from the period of 1930 to 1985. From 1985, but the situation changes from the 1985. In the government system also they made a change. From 1985, it has from presidential republic type of government. It has from presidential republic type of government. So Brazil has presidential or adopted presidential republic type of government from 1985. In the late 20th century, Brazil has faced many financial difficulties and had overcome them successfully. In the late 20th century, Brazil has faced many financial difficulties. Too much financial difficulties Brazil has faced and had to overcome them successfully in late 20th century. Today, Brazil is seen as an important country contributing to economic growth of the world and a major global market in future. Brazil is also seen as an important country contributing to economic growth, because Brazil is also trying to develop in every field, but as compared to the other countries, it is not that much developed. But it's trying its level best, increasing its import-export business, international relationship, a good relationship with other countries. Brazil is seen as one of the important countries contributing to the economic growth of the world. And it is also seen as a global market in future. Not at present, but in future, it is seen as a global market in future. So Brazil was under the rule of Portuguese for more than three centuries. From 1930 to 1985, Brazil had a military government. From 1985, it has from presidential republic type of government. In the late 20th century, Brazil has faced many financial difficulties and has overcome them successfully. Today, Brazil is seen as an important country contributing to economic growth of the world and a major global market in. Similarities between India and Brazil. What is the similarities we can see in India and Brazil? India as well as Brazil are surrounded by water bodies. We have seen the continent map also and the water bodies on the earth. And we have seen the position of India and Brazil in the map. So While observing that India as well as Brazil is surrounded by water bodies. Both the countries were under the foreign rule for many years. India was under the British rule and Brazil was under the Portuguese for many years. For more than three centuries, Brazil was under Portuguese rule and India was under the British rule for almost 1.5 centuries. So many years they have to spend under the foreign rule. Today, both the countries have republic type of government. We have seen the type of government of Brazil and India also. Both the countries have republic type of government. India has only the difference is India has parliamentary republic type of government and Brazil has presidential republic type of government. This is the only difference, but it is a republic type of government. The common people or the citizens of the country of both India and Brazil have their right for the selection or their decision to give for the government. Next, both the countries have to face various type of difficulties after independence. After independence, both the countries have to face various problems related to development of the country in every field such as education, health, defense, settlement, population, new technologies, satellite. In every field, both have to face various problems for the development of the country, for making their country underdeveloped to developing. So both the countries have to face various type of difficulties after independence, and the main problem was their financial condition. Both the countries were not that much stable and financially better for the development. So this was the main problem, economy of India and Brazil after independence they faced. Today, both the countries are considered to be an important global market. Both the countries are considered as important global market, but as compared to Brazil, India is good in global market. And it is seen that Brazil will also be better or good in its status in a global market. So today, both the countries are considered to be an important global market. Similarities, we have seen that India as well as Brazil are surrounded by water bodies. Both the countries were under the foreign rule for many years. Today, both the countries have republic type of government. Both the countries have to face various type of difficulties after independence. Today, both the countries have considered to be an important global market. These are the main points. It may be can ask in exam for the similarities between India and Brazil. So you have to keep these points in mind related to water bodies, the republic type of government, both the countries under the foreign rule, Brazil under Portuguese, India under British. India for 1.5 century and Brazil for near 3 centuries. Both the countries have to face various difficulties after independence. Today, both the countries are considered to be an important global market. So, now let's recall what we have learned in this lesson. Because we have completed this lesson, second lesson, location and extent of Brazil and India. In this, we have learned about the location and the boundaries of Brazil and India, their state, the main concept, historical background, India and Brazil. We have seen the map reading also. Now, let's recall about what we have learned in this lesson as our evaluation. The second largest populated country in the world is India. India is known for its spices. India is known for its spices all over the world. This country is known as the coffee pot of the world. Brazil is known as the coffee pot of the world. The samba dance is a distinct feature of a country, Brazil. Samba dance is famous for Brazil. It is its specialty. Capital of India, New Delhi. Capital of Brazil, Brasilia. Capital you have to keep in mind, you have to remember it. India's capital, you know, New Delhi, and Brazil is Brazil. The southernmost tip of India is called Indira Point. In Madhya Pradesh, this question many times comes. The southernmost tip of India is called Indira Point. Indira Point is located on 6 degrees 45 minutes north parallel. The location is 6 degrees 45 minutes north parallel. Number of states in India, 29. India got independence from British rule on 15 August 1947. Brazil got independence from Portuguese rule on 7 September 1822. Dates you have to remember. Brazil, India, you know, but Brazil, you have to remember, 7 September 1822. The type of government in India and Brazil is republic. Both the country, Brazil and India, the type of government they follow is republic. India is located in the northern and eastern hemisphere. India is located in the northern and eastern hemisphere. In the continent of Asia, India is located in the southern part. Continent wise, India is located in Asia, and in Asia, it is located in the southern part. Most of the Brazil is located in the southern hemisphere. Most of the Brazil is located in the southern hemisphere. In context of the prime meridian, Brazil is located in the western hemisphere. If you see of prime meridian, Brazil is located in the western hemisphere. And in the continent of South America, Brazil is located in the northern eastern. And if we see of the continent of South America, Brazil is located in the northern eastern. Important latitude passing through the middle of India is Tropic of Cancer. Right or wrong, this question comes. Important latitude passing through the middle of India is Tropic of Cancer. So in this way, we have seen the current situation of Brazil, the similarities faced by India and Brazil, the problem faced by India and Brazil after independence, why Brazil is called the coffee pot, India is looked upon as a young generation, historical background of Brazil, historical background of India. So like this, we have studied about the lesson number 2, location and extent.